The men are recovering well from the attack, but they don't understand the danger they're in. My mother warned me never to make an enemy of a witch. Corvo, here to settle our debt. You understand, I won't make this easy for you.
Thomas has returned with the information you requested. He's waiting for you below. I found Lizzie Stride. Getting her to lend us her boat will be a bit complicated, however. She's in Coldridge. From what I hear, they've got enough on her to hold her for about 1,000 years.
Coldridge. We can use this. We'll get her out. And Stride will have to pay back the favor. We'll have our transport.
Ready to leave, sir? Or should I wait?
Delilah doesn't leave Brigmore Manor anymore. She doesn't have to. Which means I have to come to her. The manor's upriver, far out past the quarantine line. I'll need a ship. I've lived in Dunwall's underworld a long time. I know the players. Gang leaders, madams, corrupt officials. But what I need is a smuggler who knows the river. Someone I can trust. It's a reflection of Dunwall. Or perhaps myself. That after all these years, the best choice I have is Lizzie Stride. And Lizzie Stride is in jail. This should get me in the front door at least. Looks like I'll need to check in with those guards by the gate.
Overseer.
About time, Overseer. We sent for you hours ago.
There was a problem with the waterlock.
Fine. Listen up. The incident took place in the interrogation room. Cross the yard and keep going straight. Anything else is off limits. Understand? Don't go exploring. Don't speak to the prisoners. We're not here to listen to you preach. Don't forget you're in Coldridge now, not the Abbey. We asked you here for one reason.
I'll be gone before you know it.
Guard! Open the gate!
This mask won't fool an arc pylon.
What's wrong? We're sending 3 men to the firing squad, and no one knows what actually happened.
Didn't they do it?
Hammered a drink, said he chose a bad day to sleep in. Morris lost his nerve at the sewer gates.
Scary.
Neither of them knew anything. They died to satisfy the Lord Regent's office.
Right through there. Can't miss it. None of the guards that went in to question her came out.
I'll be careful.
detector got out. Someone paid off a guard to give him a key. So now we've got the tumbler system.
So I have to remember a number and walk all the way back here, just to unlock a cell? Because they paid off a guard?
It makes sense to the Lord Regent's office.
They should just pay the guards more.
What happened here? This controls all the cell doors.
Better make a pass.
cleared to enter this restricted area. There's no way you're getting past here, so move.
Take my patrol.
Another night, another patrol with you.
Better make a pass over here.
Someone's about to get shot. know you're here. Come on, let's get this guy.
rough shape.
Someone's breaking out! Come quick!
All prison personnel will stay clear of the interrogation room until the representative from the Abbey has certified it is free of any heretical corruption.
alarm!
She's beaten, but not dead. See that her wounds get attention.
It will be done. Ready to go, sir?
Let's go. Dunwall is changing fast. 6 months ago, Draper's Ward was where Dunwall's rich and well-born strolled and shopped and tried to be seen. The plague burned through it in days. Today it's a battleground where two street gangs fight over the spoils. The Hatters and Lizzie's gang, the Dead Eels. Lizzie Stride was the boss until Edgar Wakefield betrayed her and took her place. And a riverboat. It's the kind of thing that happens every day in Dunwall. I don't judge him. I've done worse myself. But I need that boat. Edgar Wakefield and I have business.
textile mill used to run off a water wheel before the canal went dry. It started up again recently, and whatever the Hatters did to get it working has enraged the Dead Eels. They're fighting in the streets.
Busy making dresses.
Somebody give me a hand.
You're no scrapper.
I'll stick you. Come on, let's get this guy.
Quiet in the city. Almost like it used to be.
Limit just a few.
You get caught out when the Dead Eels come across the canal? No thanks. Every man for himself.
Hatter pride. I'm touched.
Ugh!
he's not as fun as Lizzie. Lizzie enjoyed it more.
Even Lizzie never drowned victims in a sack. Still see him squirming for air.
Yeah. How's he gonna top that?
Well... Somebody give me a hand!
Wakefield sealed himself in the cargo hold of the Undine. Smuggling ships like this one often have a hatch underneath for dumping contraband if they get caught. Perhaps the Undine is no different.
What does he do? He jumps in the water.
Very funny.
I hear Lord Shaw is making his way to the park by boat with only two bodyguards.
What? How do you hear things like that?
I have some connections.
There's the boat. Wakefield's probably keeping himself below decks. Whatever I do to him, it will be a mercy compared to what Lizzie has in mind.
Get that creepy feeling of being watched? Had that a bunch lately.
Funny you asked that. I had this feeling in my eyes. I looked up on the roof of that building over there.
There was a lady up there, right? I seen her too. Just stared. Then she was
gone. In a wink. Yeah. We've seen the same thing.
She would tell the others about it?
No. The others might think we're seeing things. First sign of the plague, from what I hear.
Lizzie's boat is smaller than I remember.
Is assuming control of the dead eels now. She's ordered them to give you safe passage.
Your friend Edgar Wakefield set me up to be taken by the City Watch, and you followed him. Took his orders. But you know what? I forgive you. All of you. I'm filled with love. But the following people each owe me a finger. Logan, Douglas, Bang Bang, Ferris, Pigface, the Bakers, and Annabelle.
Shit.
Two from you, Annabelle. Have a good night.
That piece of garbage, Edgar. I'm still living with his incompetence. He let the Hatters cripple the Undine.
Ship seems fine to me.
They took the engine coil. We're dead in the water.
What is it? Can we make a new one?
They don't make them anymore, not for an engine like the Undine's. We'll have to get it back.
The geezer still leads the Hatter gang, right? I'll pay him a visit.
It won't be that easy. There's a snag.
Always is. What's this one?
The geezer's about 100 years old by now. He's got it rigged so that if he dies, the whole place gets gassed. So they're real careful around him. Got him a nurse and everything. Maybe you can cut a deal for that engine coil. Turn on the charm. One of the Hatters gave me their door password in exchange for keeping the rest of his fingers. It's whalebone. I never got to use it on account of the gas. And being in jail.
Just be ready to move when I get back.
This place is dead. Pity. You really think the outsider ain't real? What'd I see Dowd do then?
Just because he can do strange things, doesn't mean there's an invisible man watching us. I'll ask him how he does it.
Are you crazy? Don't you dare.
What's the password?
Whalebone.
Come in, Hatter.
Sir. The Hatters are using the textile machines to make shrouds for the plague dead.
Now we know why they took the engine coil.
The man who runs the Hatters is more cunning than he looks. He can flood this place with a toxic gas. In time, it'll eat through our air filters. You may have to make a deal.
Corvo Otana with her. They weren't wearing no clothes.
Keep your hat on. I was just asking.
Just because you're in charge of the gate, it don't mean the rest of us. Idiots.
Yeah? Well, since you're such a genius, it ought to be real easy to see who it was. So go check it out.
Fine. I don't know why you're worried about nothing. Settled in over here. Just a matter of time, buddy.
Don't let him get past.
Someone's about to get shanked. Help me look for him. That's it.
Where'd you
He's
run
gone.
Off?
Just a matter of time, buddy. I'll find him. Where'd you run off to? Just a matter of time, buddy.
Miscalculated.
My name's Dowd. I'm looking for Lizzie Strive's missing engine coil. I'm giving you a chance to make a deal.
Is it worth all this something to take on out of?
Yes, sir. Very reasonable offer. Geezer here says you're in luck. We only need that engine coil because someone shut off the flow that turns our water wheel. I sent men into the sewers to restore the flow, and not one of them came back. But what stopped them won't be a problem for the famous Dowd, will it? When the water flows, I'll give you the engine coil. Here's the key to the sewer entrance, and it's a pleasure to do business with you, Mr. Dowd. The Hatters will behave themselves.
As long as you keep your end of the bargain, Dowd.
You're not a weaver, are you? Please, I think my knees hurt.
Thank you.
she's afraid of us. When the change comes, she'll only want the weaker sisters nearby.
That makes no sense. Our power flows from Delilah. Without her, we'd be reduced to dancing under the moon in parlor tricks. You must be wrong.
Why else would she put us here, right in his path? I wish he'd hurry up and come already. What?
Help me! Lay down!
Threat.
Thank you.
What are you?
It's done, but I don't think you'll see your men again.
No survivors. Tell me something.
Caesar says a deal's a deal. The code is 984.
fighting. Wonder how long that'll last.
Please, do the honors, Dowd. Fire up the engine from the brig. Get us underway.
The Brigmores were an ancient family, bankrupted a generation ago. Since then, the manor has housed two street gangs, a smuggling ring, innumerable rats, and the Brigmore witches. I'd always left them alone, but now a painter named Delilah had taken up witchcraft and formed a coven. She was trying something. A ritual. But what kind? The outsider knows. I cannot abide a mystery.
I scouted, sir. They've locked the front, and I've seen evidence of snares. Also, maybe it's nothing, but I spotted several statues of the woman Delilah. I don't know what it means, but I thought it was worth mentioning.
It means trouble. Anything else?
They're getting in and out of the house somehow, but I haven't spotted it. Sorry, sir. Best I can do.
Good enough. I'll take it from here.
Thank you.
Everything is in order, sir. Strange doings, sir. I killed a hound in the yard, and it got straight back up and went for me. I had to crush its skull, to be sure.
Soon or stay for another season.
Please, I'm sick of hearing about it. I'm on your side, because I'm not. If you raise a hand to any of my sisters but Delilah, you'll answer to me.
Understood. What have you got?
When her ritual's done, Emily Caldwin's mind will be gone. and Delilah will look out through her eyes the rest of her life.
And Delilah will rule as Empress.
That's up to you. I've got my money. That's all I need.
Wait. What about a way in?
Use the crypt. There's a lever that opens one of the tombs. The lever is kept in the shed. That's all I can tell you. What might this be?
You're going to suffer when I find you.
Lost.
Show yourself, little toad. Oh, I'll find you. Come out! Now! I'll have your eyes! Come out, dear. It's no use. Where are you?
Where are you?
What a distance was run down.
the new sister settled in yet? Will she last, I wonder? Someone should be here. I'll watch for our enemies.
Me eat anymore. I can't.
What happened to you?
I denounce the oracles. The oracles. They saw. The Caldwell girl is the key. The girl in the painting.
Where's Delilah?
Sisters, over here. To the boys with you.
Should be here. I'll watch for our enemies. Lady Delilah feast us with a brace of rabbits too.
Really, sister. You ought to have your mind on more important things.
Thank you.
They say Rothwild claims he fought off the assassin Dowd in his slaughterhouse.
I don't think a fool like Wild would have seen Dowd coming, much less fought him off.
There must be something to the story. What did he want, you think? It's not like him to leave a target living.
Getting old, maybe. You don't think he asked about the ship, the Delilah?
You don't get old in Dowd's position without seeing things other people don't.
Nothing to worry about, my love. Nothing after all. I'll watch for our enemies. One of my dear sisters has wandered.
Oh, yes, my dear. Oh, yes.
among us.
So Delilah wants to use Emily to become Empress.
Listen for the heels of his boots. He is here, I tell you.
Is the new sister settled in yet? Will she last, I wonder?
I wish I knew. Where?
No use.
You must I'll find you.
Show yourself.
Nothing after all. Oh, I know you're here.
Sisters, over here.
Strike it.
My lady, do
I'll eat your heart. Yeah.
You have many talents, Dowd, and they've served you. Delilah's talents are quite different. She creates images, but she does more. She captures spirit. She insinuates her will into her subject, whatever it is. We're witnessing her masterpiece, and perhaps yours as well. I gave you Delilah's name, and you followed it to this moment. You see now what hangs in the balance. Emily's life, Delilah's ambition, an empire in the act of crumbling. In your long life, I've rarely seen you act with such consummate grace. I give my mark sparingly, and I don't play favorites. But I will watch this with unusual attention.
The Void. Time to see what you've really got, Delilah.
Dowd. Well, you've lived up to my expectations.
creeping in like a mouse. The mouse of Dunwall. I must say, I'm surprised you came this far. You're the one who gave me this chance in the first place. I thought I might see the Lord Protector pop up at the last minute, but never you.
I suspect Corvo's busy.
Are you doing this for Emily? Don't bother. You killed her mother in front of her and sold her to a gang of murderous crooks. You think she's fit for the throne? No. The girl Emily Caldwin will have the mind of Delilah the First, who did not inherit everything she got, but came to power through the force of her own genius.
Your genius couldn't keep me from reaching you. It won't save you now.
Oh. Who have your victims been, Dowd? Civil servants? The housekeeping staff? Drunken boys on watch duty and frail old aristocrats? None like me. Your mother should have taught you not to anger a witch. I'll kill you!
Delilah's work. She's been busy.
Come on.
No one will ever know exactly what it took to save Emily Caldwin from a living death as Delilah's puppet. No one except the outsider, who watches everything and thinks his own dark thoughts and speaks to few in any generation. I've learned that our choices always matter. To someone. Somewhere. And sooner or later, in ways we can't always fathom, the consequences come back to us. I came from Cirkonos to Dunwall as a boy, made my living as a killer, one of the few who've heard the outsider's voice. I murdered an empress, but saved her daughter, who will one day rule the empire. Those were my choices. I'm ready for what comes. Surprise for you. I asked for my life. When I killed your empress and took her daughter, something broke inside me. Now I want nothing but to leave this city and fade from the memory of those who reside here. I've had enough killing. So my life is in your hands. Make your choice.
You make an eloquent plea. For a man with innocent blood on his hands. It's a shame Corvo doesn't know the real story, isn't it? How in these last days you passed through Coldridge Prison like a shadow, dared the tangles of Dunwall's underworld, and walked out unscathed, outwitted one of the greatest witches in a generation, all with consummate care and skill. How you saved Emily Caldwin, daughter of the Empress, first of her name, and no one will ever know. But how does it end for Dowd, the hired killer, the murderer, the savior of the Empire? It's up to Corvo now.